In this tutorial, I will teach you how to access data from GSP page. We are using MySQL database and we have a table called book details where there is a field for ID, then book name and author. And this is the SQL to create the table. So, first of all, create the books database. MySQL minus root minus e root. So we have connected to the MySQL server and now creating the books table. It is created. Now we are connecting books database. So tables. There is no table in the database. Now this is the query to create a table called books details. So it is created. Let's check the table. Show tables. So this is the table. Now we have book details table. And next thing is to create the web application in Eclipse. Write the GSP page and then test the code. So first step is to create the project, new dynamic web project, GSP access database, click next and then select generate web.xml deployment descriptor and click on finish. And within the lib directory, we have to add the libraries to connect to the MySQL database. So we have pasted it here and in the project. Now we should create a new GSP file. And here we'll create a link. Books detail. And the name should be book entry form.jsp. This is the link. Now we'll create a new GSP file. We'll name it as book entry.jsp. Click finish. And this is the code. We can directly copy it here. And we have to change the database URL. Books is a table and the username is root and password is root. So let's run the example first. Run as on Java server. Since Tomcat is already embedded with this Eclipse, we can run the project right away. So it is giving error that access denied for user root localhost. So there seems some error. So this is the error actually here. Now right click and run as on server. Click finish. So now there is no error. Book name Java book 1. And this is the author, submit. So this is added. And if we select asterisk from books underscore details. So it is here. And now we can go back again. JSP book 1. So it is also added. So this way this program runs, and this is a very simple program in JSP which adds the data into the database as well as display the data from the database. So let's see how it works. Actually, we have a project, and here this is index.jsp file, and this file is loaded when application is accessed. So this is the default file, and here we have a link for bookform.jsp. So in the bookform.jsp, we have using the MySQL driver, and it is connecting to the database localhost books database with the username root and password root, and connection is created. So if the action is not null, means form is submitted by entering the author name and book, then it is getting the data request.get parameter book name. So this is the form, and it is getting the value book name and author from this entry form. And then there is SQL insert into books detail book name and author, and these are the values. And with the help of statement object, it is executing the query. And then there is another query for getting the data, statement dot select asterisk from book details, and it is selected the data, and now it is displaying all the data from the database. So while RST has next, it is displaying book name and the author, and finally closing the record set statement and the connection. And this is a JavaScript validation for validating the form. So please enter book name. Similarly, please enter author name. So this can be a very simple program for you in JSP which accesses the data from MySQL database. You can download the source code from our website for this project and use it for experimenting with the JSP and MySQL. This is the tutorial details here, and you can download the code from here. So first of all, we created a database. The next is create table. Then in Eclipse, we created the project, and this is the JSP file for inserting the data and displaying from the database. So we have thousands of tutorials on JSP programming on our website roseindia.net, and you can learn all these JSP tutorials by visiting our website. Apart from this, we have tutorials on advanced Java, Hibernate framework, Struts framework, XML, Spring, Java testing framework, databases, Ajax, and so on. And we have video tutorials on JDBC also that you can visit and learn the detail about the JDBC programming. And we have tutorials on Hibernate and other frameworks, Hibernate, Spring, and so on. So visit our website and learn all these technologies. Thanks for viewing the tutorial.